who play an essential part in our team, league, facility, and community. Without these individuals, we would not be where we are at today. Please give a round of applause to the president of Assiniboia Minor Hockey, Jared Rosica. The president of the Richardson Pioneer Southern Rebels, Dale Berner. Please welcome the president of the Prairie Junior Hockey League, Mike Zambon. The mayor of Assiniboia, Her Worship, Sharon Schoenberg. From Nelson Motors, a major sponsor of the Richardson Pioneer Southern Rebels and the and behind bringing this new facility to the community, Mr. Curtis Nelson. And Director of Operations for Richardson Pioneer, former Rebel alumni and the main reason why Richardson Pioneer is the Rebels' biggest sponsor, Cam Elder. Can we please have, joining us at center ice, the captains of the Carrot River Outback Thunder, David Weens, and from the Richardson Pioneer Southern Rebels, Aiden Sigvason. And here to drop the ceremonial puck from Richardson Pioneer, Cam Elder. Thank you, gentlemen. Next, we have a video message from Jan Arden.
Well, hello everyone, I am Jan Arden, and I am so happy to be here virtually. I wish I could be there in person for this most auspicious occasion of the opening of this brand new facility. Congratulations, I know a lot of hard work went into this. Assiniboia, you are the heart of Saskatchewan, you already know that. And I know that hockey is such a big, huge part of that heart of your community. So I'm happy to be here to sing the national anthem to you today. And for the Richardson Pioneer Southern Rebels Junior Hockey Club, hope I got that right. Keep kicking butt. Congratulations on being a team for so many decades. And congratulations to everyone. If you could please stand for the singing of the national anthem.
Wasn't that something else? Congratulations, Rod. Good job on that that whole thing. That was fantastic.
It went okay. Thank you, sir.
You did very well. Hey, listen, let's see. We're going to take a short time out here, and we'll be right back with more hockey action right after this on Cat Country 98. Thank you.
of the Thunder, and we are underway from Assiniboia on this Saturday night. And the puck is rocked by Tyler Rock into the Assiniboia zone. Back to handle it behind the goal. Matt Morehart, starting defenseman, rolling it up the left wing toward the line. It's held in, and a quick shot from the line by Matthew Ratzlaff is steered in back of the goal by Coulter Meeling, starting goalie tonight for the Southern Rebels out of Cottam, Ontario. Now a long shot from the left point from Tyler Rock is held on to by Meeling, and he'll hold on, and the shot clock doesn't reflect it, but two quick shots at the early going here by the visiting Carrot River Outback Thunder had the Southern Rebels on their heels a little bit. The faceoff on the right side of Meeling. You'll have to, what should I say, excuse us a little bit. The black jerseys with blue numbers are a little hard to pick up the numbers of the Southern Rebels, but we'll get to it. Left point in the Assiniboia zone. Drayden Hivetson drills it around the goal. Comes out here to this right point, and the long shot by A.J. True is blocked. Down on the backboards is Brock Smith. Swift Current product throws it right up the middle. Connected at center by Carter Lamont. He'll dangle over the Carrot River line and stab it in back of the Thunder goal. By a centering feed from there, but it doesn't go. There's a battle down behind the Carrot River net. Digging away at it. I think it's Morehart. Comes out to the left point here for Parker Sweeting. And his long shot is wide. Picked up on the far left wing boards by Tristan Caron of Carrot River. Thrown across in front of their goal. And A.J. True is away with speed through center. Long slap shot in. Affords his mates a change. And now it is iced here by the Southern Rebels. Hammered all the way down. We'll get another faceoff in the Assiniboia zone. It was sent all the way down by Chase Tenatuik. He is a Moose Jaw product, and there are several Moose Javians Hurricane on this roster.
You know the boys are from Moose Jaw. You know they're going to do well in this league, right?
Yes. I want to say hi to everybody from Moose Jaw listening tonight. I know you get a lot of listeners.
Yeah, you know, I bet you there's a few other people up there listening too in our industry. I would like to say hi to them. You know who you are. Carnes, nice to see you, buddy. I bet you he's listening online right now.
I would. Well, what else would he be doing on a Saturday night? Right wing boards in the Assiniboia zone. Parker Sweeting rolls it out to center. Jumping puck blocked on the Carrot River line and fed ahead to center. And rolling in is Aiden Hansen with it. Can't get a shot to the goal. Puck bounces down into the right-hand corner. Now centered all the way out to the left point. Quick shot, they score! Ryan McNee! Past a screen, Coulter Meeling, and the Carrot River Outback Thunder open the scoring here tonight, and they are stunned in the Sherwood.
Wow.
Yeah.
What just happened there, Rod? My goodness. That's not a good way to start out the game here tonight, but it is what it is. I didn't get a chance to see who scored that one.
It was 11, Ryan McNee. He's from Valemont, BC.
Oh, well, there we go. Well, that sometimes happens.
See if we can pick up the announcement on it. It comes 2:08 into the game. And it's an even strength goal. And I'm telling you right now, he's getting rough. He's picking up the announcement on the end. 22, Beauchamp, and 18, Larry Fleck with the assist on the goal. And it's 1-0 Carrot River. Now a long wrist shot from just inside the Carrot River line, taken by Jaden Lupeliak. Handled by the starting Carrot River netminder, Amden Moran. We'll get our first faceoff in the Carrot River zone. Draw man coming out for Assiniboia is Aiden Sigvason. He's from Sylvan Lake, Alberta, and he will take the draw against the captain Weens of Carrot River. And the Southern Rebels won the draw. The point shot from Jordan Rayner is blocked, trickles over to the right-hand corner of the Carrot River zone. Niftily kicked out of there by Tyler Rock, the big lanky defenseman. Skated on the left wing boards, far side by Blake Lahonen, and he can't get his shot to the goal. Rebound, brought around in front, and whacking away at it was David Weems, and he couldn't beat the Rebels' goaltender, Coulter Meeling. Now a long point shot, it's tipped just up and over the net by Todd Pankratz, a Priestville, Saskatchewan product, and now Carrot River has some sustained pressure in the Assiniboia zone again. Puck picked up along the near left wing boards, and it is skated to center by Assiniboia. Shot in by Jordan Rayner. Gloved down by Morin, the Carrot River goalie. Both teams get a change or two up front. It is skated out to center ice. Here is Salisbury, right wing of center, right below it. Sends it cross ice, far side of center, and it is dealt into the Assiniboia zone by Lee Burt. Now a free puck in front, and a quick high shot by Cliff Salisbury is smothered by Colter Meelin, and he will hold on.
All right, Rod, we'll take a quick break here, if that's okay with you. Be right back.
Great West.
Your sponsorship.
Trey Hartle is the draw man for Carrot River in the offensive zone. Picks it up in the slot. Can't get a shot away. Lost it in his own skates. Spinning and firing now was Larry Flett, but it's kicked out by Meelin. The starting Assiniboia goalies from Cottam, Ontario. Colter Meelin. And now it's in the left, far left corner of the Assiniboia zone, and it is deflected off ice by the Southern Rebels' Jaden Lupeliak. He takes a header on the forecheck right into the Carrot River net, sends it flying. And by the way, I know we're on radio, but folks, it's a standing room only crowd. There's people still filing in here, Hurricane. They can't even find a place to stand.
This is absolutely mind-blowing. If you haven't been to the Southland Co-op Center yet, there's standing room with rails around it, and of course, what would you call this, a ledge that you can eat off of, have a drink off of, and there's not a single place left.
Nothing.
Yeah.
Come early. That's the message.
Absolutely.
Carter Lamotte, the draw man for Assiniboia outside the Carrot River line. It's the Thunder that come up with it. Loose puck in front of their bench now. Far side, Tristan Caron, who's got the game's only goal. No, it's McNee who's got their goal. Here's Caron. Busting free. He's tripped. Coming over the Assiniboia line. And Carrot River's going to go to the power play here momentarily as it's touched in the corner by Brock Smith, and he's the offending party. Assiniboia's number 24, Brock Smith. He's a Swift Current product. And Carrot River, who's already got the advantage in this game, will go to a power play for the first time.
I don't know if we'll be able to pick up the call here or not.
It's okay.
Got the number? We're good?
Yeah.
All right. Hey, can you tell I've never done color before, Rod?
Very much.
I can tell you're excited about the whole thing.
I think, hey, when I heard you were doing color, I was actually very excited. Oh. I'm happy for that. We're going to give this power play, even though it's for Carrot River, we'll say for Moose Jaw Truck Shop. What do you say?
Love it.
For the whole game. For both teams. But this might not be a good thing as Carrot River controls. And the Assiniboia zone, the long shot is tipped in on Meelin. And from the butterfly, he'll cover up and hold on as Carrot River has come to play tonight. You heard the scouting report from Dale Werner, the president of the Rebels. Like, these guys are big, they're fast, they fight hard. Yep, you got the right team.
I would be 100% behind you on that save.
David Weens wins the faceoff for Carrot River in the Assiniboia zone, and the long point shot comes from Drayton Havidson, held onto by Meelin, and the faceoff will be to his right side. Colter Meelin, starting goalie for Assiniboia, is from Cottam, Ontario. Reminds me a little bit of Teabag. Jerry Hack, the starting goalie for Assiniboia back in the 80s, from Vancouver, B.C. They don't like their homegrown goalies here, apparently, at Assiniboia.
Bring them out to Assiniboia, right? That's how that works.
A.J. True skates in on right wing for Carrot River. Down this near right wing side, centering pass is broken up nicely by Matt Moorhart of Assiniboia, but the puck stays in the Rebels' zone, far left corner. Todd Pankratz in there for Carrot River at center, and what a stop by Mealing. And now I see why they got him in goal. A flash the leather, as they like to say. Lightning fast glove save. Keeps it 1-0 Carrot River.
Those boys have to stretch for that, or is that...
Oh, yeah.
I was going to say, his one leg was one direction, the other direction.
Very flexible young man. Nathan Coombs is the draw man for Carrot River. He's a local Carrot River kid up there north of PA. But the puck is secured in the Assiniboia zone by Evan Krasowski. On the penalty kill, he'll fire it all the way down. A minute to go in the Carrot River power play. They lead this hockey game 1-0 in Assiniboia. 6 minutes into the contest. Skated into the Assiniboia zone by Carrot River's Trey Handel on the right wing wall. Circles around the net to the far left corner. And up the boards with it still. Drops it off at the line for Tyler Rock. Into the slot area, and Parker Sweeting had his man tied up well. Defenseman for Assiniboia. The zone's cleared all the way down. 38 seconds to go in the power play here for Carrot River and Moose Jaw Truck Shop as the Rebels get a change. Jordan Rayner out there to kill the penalty along with Matt Moorhart, Aiden Sigvason, and Jordan Johnson. Jordan Johnson, one of a bunch of Moose Jaw kids on this team, at least three that I count. Skated in by Coons for Carrot River on the right wing boards, left in the right hand circle for Aiden Hansen. He'll stop on the wall, out to the line for Trey Hardy. Left point, Tyler Rock's shot hit a stick, and now it's tipped out of the zone. We get a foot race for it, but the Carrot River defenseman, Tyler Rock's going to be back first ahead of Sigfusson. And he protects it in his own zone here as the penalty is now up, and Carrot River is 0-for-1 on the power play in this game. Almost too many men call on Assiniboia, but they got away with it. Stick handling through center for Carrot River on the far left wing side is Nathan Koontz. Hit along the boards. It comes free to the left point for Hadley Nakaneshny. Now a shot from the middle point from Lee Burtis, steered into the corner by the netminder Colter Mealing for Assiniboia. Puck comes up the far right wing boards, and it's backhanded out by Carter Lamont. Carrot River back in. Patineau to shot from the right. Whistles wide, but not by much. You hear Hurricane whistling there. On the far right wing boards, Carter Lamont for the Rebels. Threw it up the middle. It's blocked. Doesn't get out. Comes back in behind the Assiniboia goal. Now far corner. Down to get it is Matt Moorhart. Assiniboia kid. A long lead feed. It's a breakaway pass. Flawless the shot. And the save made by Andon Morin. What a beautiful stretch pass for the breakaway. And Aiden Lawless was repelled by the Carrot River netminder, Andon Morin. Whoa, big hit in the Assiniboia zone. Action's picking up here now. 1-0. Carrot River leads, 11:37 to go in this first period. And they're out shooting Assiniboia 10-3 on the Chucks collision shot clock. Shot from the left circle in the Assiniboia zone, kicked out by Mealing, and here come the Rebels with the rebound. Near left wing of center, Rhett Franklin will deal it in. Rolling around the Carrot River net. Tyler Rock picks it up first, and now it's swatted all the way down. That was Patineau, I believe. It's going to be an icing call with 11:11 to go here in this first period. We'll take a timeout. 1-0 Carrot River. This is Richard.
We take our...
Yeah!
Great West Auto.
That's not to say that Assiniboia can't come back, but it sure seems to me like they've had a lot of nerves here tonight as Carrot River netminder Andon Morin covers up on a dump in, and the faceoff will be to his left side. 2-0, Carrot River leads this hockey game.
Looking at the shot clock, Carrot River is quite a team right out of the
fairly lopsided. Carter Lamont will take the faceoff here for Assiniboia against Trey Hartle of the Carrot River Thunder. And on the draw, the puck jumps out toward the right point. Patineau took up. No, that is Flett took off without it. Comes free in front of the Carrot River net. And the shot by the Rebels' Carter Lamont is blocked. Rebound comes in behind their goal. Here's the announcement. Todd Pankratz and David Williams with the assist on the goal. And the action is all the way back down to the Assiniboia. And now in behind the cage, Tanner Patineau tried to center and had it blocked. And now we got a penalty upcoming as it's getting a little chippy down there, Steve. But I've watched enough hockey to know this is just frustration coming out on both teams. And I think both sides getting a penalty. No, just one. Looks like Assiniboia is going to power play. And that might be what the doctor ordered here right now.
Might be a change in attitude here right now. I think, looking at this, these two teams side by side, I think Assiniboia's got to cut out for them tonight. There's definitely a size difference here, too.
Aiden Sigvason wins the faceoff cleanly for Assiniboia in the Carrot River zone. Handled here at the left point by Logan Fontaine. The long shot blockered into the corner by Morin. Here on the left wing boards, Jaden Lupeliak. Long shot, so there's wide of the Carrot River goal. Out to the left point here, Lupeliak. Down the left wing boards for Fontaines. Handles it in the left circle here near side of the Carrot River zone. He's centered and it's jammed wide by Jordan Johnson. And the rebounded puck is flipped up by Lee Burke. Here's a breakup ice. Cliff Salisbury hit hard coming into the Assiniboia zone. Puck taken away and skated up ice by Jordan Rayner. No, that is Jaden Lupeliak, and he is stick checked in the center ice faceoff circle. And it's taken all the way back in behind the Assiniboia net by the Rebels' Jordan Johnson as he sets up on the power play here. 1:09 to go in this power play for the Rebels. Long shoot in, a knuckleballer by Parker Sweeting is handled by Andon Morin. He'll hold on. What's up?
Nothing. I'm just, there's a heck of a good shot there. I thought maybe he'd have a good, better shot. Yeah, it was kind of like you said, a knuckleball. She was headed down pretty quick.
But Andon Morin wasn't fooled. The goalie from Carrot River, who calls Nipawin home. Off the faceoff, it is blasted out by Tyler Rock, and the Rebels have to go back in their own zone to retreat and set up on the power play here. 50 seconds to go on their man advantage. 8:25 to go in the first period. Carrot River leads 2-0. Evan Krasowski's stick handles all the way down for Assiniboia, deep into the Carrot River zone, stops in the far right circle. Pass to the line is tipped by the waiting defenseman by Carrot River's Todd Pankratz. Handled at center and brought in now by Matt Morhart for the Rebels. He'll stuff it in behind the Carrot River goal. All the way to the far right corner, there's a battle for it in there. Puck is dug free and hammered down the ice here by Ryan McNee. He's got one of the two Carrot River goals. He goes off for a change here with 15 seconds left in the Assiniboia power play. They have managed one power play shot on it. Power plays for Moose Jaw, truck shot. Free puck in the near corner. A.J. True for Carrot River. Couldn't get it out. We're back to five aside as you heard everybody yell even. Here's Weens trucking down the right wing side for Carrot River. Slows up. Pass out front is into the skates of his line mate, Blake Lahonen. And play is blown down here with 7:22 to go in the first period. What do we got coming up in the first intermission, Hurricane?
First intermission, we are going to hopefully get Curtis Nelson back up here again to talk a little bit more about the future of this facility here. This is kind of what we wanted to do today, is kind of focus in on what this is going to mean for the community over the next little while.
He teased that there are some interesting things coming up. They're not done the fundraising, is the sense that I got.
No, we didn't get a chance to talk more about that at the start of the pregame show.
All right, and looking forward to that chat. 2-0, Carrot River leads here. And twice now, Assiniboia, I think, has gotten away with too many men penalties. It's been an undisciplined showing so far for your hometown Southern Rebels, but it's opening that a long way to go. But we'll see if they shake it off here after the first period. The puck is behind the Assiniboia goal. Parker Sweeting couldn't clear it out. It's out to the right point. Jay Chu, the long shot, doesn't get to the net. And it is brought ahead by Jordan Rayner of the Rebels. Check that. Well, number six, they say, but he's not on my roster. So let's just say it's Jordan Rayner. And I think we got an icing call, I think, on the Rebels. The faceoff's coming back into the Assiniboia zone.
You know, after that first penalty, Rod, I thought maybe the Rebels would catch a little more energy out of that. But unfortunately, it doesn't seem to have happened yet. So.
No, I just think they look nervous, man.
Big hometown team, crowd like this tonight in a new facility. I guess there's a few things going on.
Maybe I jinxed them in the pregame show for Integra Tire Assiniboia. By the way, this first period is brought to you by Western Lumber. Can I say it off my top of my head with locations in Rolla, Weyburn, and Assiniboia?
And Moose Jaw.
And Moose Jaw. Thank you. You're waiting.
I was waiting for that one.
Puck is just inside the Assiniboia line. It is stabbed up ice by Rayner, back here to the Carrot River stripe, now in front of their goal. Trey Hartle, defenseman, passes it up. Through center, it's tipped down into the Assiniboia zone. Icing is waved up. Going back to get it is Parker Sweeting. He plays a ton. He's from Merrifield, Saskatchewan. And now the puck is brought through center. It's a 2-on-1 for the Rebels. Marhart down the left side. Centers off a skate of Logan Fontaine, but not on goal. And now tipped just wide from in front by Lapulia. This is the most sustained pressure that the Rebels have had all game. More hardest stick check just inside the Carrot River line, and the puck comes up ice. Back here for it, Dacey Timmons for the Rebels. Pass through center, and here's a break. Lupeliak, he can't catch up to the puck. We got a penalty coming up now, and it's going to be on Carrot River as the Southern Rebels have some life here. Tristan Caron touched the puck in his zone for Carrot River. Assiniboia is going back to a second power play.
You know, the boys are heading towards the net a little more there. That was an unfortunate fortunate opportunity taken away because they had a pretty nice little break on that one. So hopefully this will help out a little.
Yes, the momentum may carry over here. Second power play for Assiniboia in the game. 5:19 to go. Just imagine a deep playoff run. This place rocking like this.
This place will be insane if we can get there. Got to win the first game, though. I think that's always the key.
Southern Rebels down 2-0 late first period. And now here's a breakaway. Short-handed. David Weems in for Carrot River to the backhand. He stopped by Healy. Nice stop there.
That was something else. That was something else.
But I don't know. Rebels got to really wake up here. And quick, here's another break, and it's flipped just wide by Lahonen, who's already got one for Carrot River. Now the Rebels were able to clear their zone. Here's Retzlaff back on the Carrot River line right down below us. Long lead feed is on the tape of Weems, but he couldn't get it to sit at the Assiniboia line. Carrot River's had more chances so far, and they're down a man. And now they've drawn a penalty as Matthew Retzlaff was tugged at, charging toward the Assiniboia goal. The power play's now over for the Rebels. We'll be 4-on-4. It's Parker Sweeting going to get the gate.
That is undisciplined if I've ever seen it. My goodness.
What? You played a little hockey back in the day, right?
Briarcrest. Well, Briarcrest and down to Avonlea. They called me Old Spaghetti Legs.
Did they?
Oh, absolutely. Old Spaghetti Legs has got the puck. No, he doesn't.
That's how we both ended up on the radio.
Yeah. Face for radio for me, anyways. You're on TV.
4-on-4 hockey here as the Rebels get it out of their zone. Brock Smith brought it to center, but got checked. Puck is free on the Assiniboia line. Evan Krasowski passed through center, unable to pick it up. was Jordan Johnson. And Carrot River dashes back in. It's dealt in behind the net. Forechecking is Cliff Salisbury for Carrot River, and he's called on a gloved-ahead pass, and the faceoff's going to come outside the zone. I'll tell you what, a lot of you've talked about the pressure on the Southern Rebels. If you ever get a chance to get a tour of this facility, take it. All those championship banners on the wall outside the dressing room, that's motivational stuff.
Absolutely. I think there's even some behind us here, too, as well. Right above us, above the Cat Country tent here. My goodness.
It's a franchise that's used to winning. Not tonight, and that's why there's a hush over this crowd. With 4 minutes to go in the first period, the visiting Carrot River Outback Thunder leading 2-0. I'm assuming they're sponsored by Outback Steakhouse. Here's a break. Free puck back at the Assiniboia line. Winning the foot race back to get it is Morehart. He's a fast one. Rolls it through center ice. Jordan Johnson gave it up. And for the Thunder, Larry Flett is in the other way. Larry Flett drops his shoulder. Far left wing. Stops in the corner. Nifty stick work there, but he can't walk by the rear guard, Landon McClellan. Karen Port product playing for your Rebels. Puck comes to the left point. Drayton Havidson of the Thunder rolls it in around the Assiniboia goal. The penalty is up now. Carrot River goes to a power play for the second time tonight. And this is for Moose Jaw Truck Shop.
Looking at that shot clock, that is a huge discrepancy.
13-5, make it 14-5 as Drayton Havidson rolls a long shot in, a wrist shot on Meeling. Coulter Meeling. This kid is on pace to face 45 shots in the game, and we're not even out of the first period yet.
That is something else. 3 minutes left. Yeah, you're right. 40, yeah, you should be around 45 shots this game.
And it's a power play for 31 more seconds for Carrot River. Faceoff will be to the right side of Meeling. The draw man for the Rebels is Carter Lamont. But it's a face-off win by Trey Hartle, Carrot River kid. And Thunder controls here in the right wing circle. A high wrist shot by Hartle off the shoulder of Meeling. Rebounds blasted wide. That Nathan Koontz has a heavy shot for the Thunder as the puck rattles all the way around and out. On Carrot River, they got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five local kids out of 20. That's quite a few.
That's a great ratio. Man.
Now five skaters aside. Carrot River 0 for 2 on the power play tonight. Puck in the center ice, face-off circles. Now jammed into the Assiniboia zone by Koontz, that Carrot River defenseman. Puck is behind the Assiniboia net. Backhanded up the boards by Evan Krasowski to the near point. Held in briefly, but now skated ahead to center by the Rebels' Brock Smith. Drop pass, kicked out. Quick shot came from Logan Fontaine, and Andon Morin made a great save for the Thunder. Rebound is chipped in back of the goal by Morehart as the Thunder break out. Long pass to center as Arendt. Morehart back on the Assiniboia line, ices it the other way, and they'll be called for it with 1:44 left in this first period. Faceoff will be down to the left side of Coulter Meeling in the Rebels zone.
You know, I love to see these guys just pick up the pace just a little bit. My goodness, you know, Rod, these young kids, they gotta skate faster. That's what they gotta do here.
Well, right now, Carrot River just looks like the better team. There's no two ways about that. But a game can change. There's a lot of time left in this one, in this hockey game.
Two more periods, Roddy. We got lots of time here.
Curtis Nelson coming up in the first intermission, by the way, for Nelson Motors. You're president of the Civic Improvement Association here in Assiniboia. Big night for him. Morehart in the center circle for the Rebels. A long pass, jumping puck at the Carrot River line. It eludes Fontaine from the far left wing boards. Tanner Patnode of the Thunder. Bat makes a little behind the back feed. It comes out of the zone and back to get it at center here. Jordan Reeder for the Rebels. He'll roll it in, but not far. It's promptly cleared by the Thunder's Ratzlaff. We're in the final minute of the first period. And now the Thunder ice it. It's waved off. Sweeting back for the Rebels, leaving it behind his goal for Brock Smith. Long pass to center. Failed to click with Jordan Johnson. It's free on the Carrot River line. Drayton Havidson will pass to center ice. Blocked by the Rebels' Sweeting, and he'll dump it back into the Carrot River zone with 30 seconds to go in the period. Thunder, give it up, coming out. Big hit at the line, though, as Sigvason tried to charge to the net and was interrupted by a Carrot River defenseman. A.J. True takes it behind the Thunder net. Started up the right side, stops, tries it again. Right side feed here for Beauchamp is blocked at the line and stabbed back in deep by Jordan Johnson of the Thunder. Rebels, 5 seconds to go in the period. And back to kill the clock out is Braden Havidson, who takes a late shot on the buzzer, but nothing develops out of that. And we're through 20 minutes of play here in the first ever junior game in the Southland Co-op Center. Carrot River leads 2-0. This first period's been brought to you by Westrum Lumber. And our first intermission show is on the way next. You are listening to Richardson Pioneer, Assiniboia Southern Rebels Hockey on Cat Country. We'll be right back.
on a consistent uniform short.
We'll be right back. Richardson Pioneer Rep. I bump it above Great West on. Now, here's Ron Peterson.
And just like that, we are underway with second period play-by-play from Southland Co-op Center. 2-0 the visiting Carrot River Thunder lead the hockey game. The Thunder are in white uniform. I actually love their uniforms. They're white base with maroon and gold trim. The Rebels in their traditional black with blue and orange trim, and the puck is worked down into the Assiniboia zone here. Side of the net, it squirts in front. Mealing couldn't leap out and jump on it. The Rebels goalie, it's flipped high in the air and out by Sigvason, Assiniboia's captain. And it's back in the Carrot River zone in front of their goal. Totter Rock, a long pass is in behind the intended target. Trey Hartle icing his way off into the Assiniboia zone. Mealing out to play it, but it's stolen and taken behind the Assiniboia net. Overskating it is Lee Burt. You try to work it in front and could not. It goes to the far right corner of the Assiniboia zone. Centered now, and Salisbury drills it over the net. Jumping puck at the side of the cage, going for the wraparound attempt. Was Burt, didn't go. Now a point shot blocked, and the Rebels have a chance to break out here. Left wing of center, it is dealt into the Carrot River zone by Jordan Johnson, who will go off for a change. We're just over a minute into this second period. We got a trip up coming here. A delayed call. Skated into the Assiniboia zone by Trey Hartle and blasted over the net. Comes around to the near corner. Now as it's touched up along the wall, we get the call. And Carter Lamont went down, but he's after the play, but he's back up and he wants a word with the Carrot River forward. Tristan Karen, it's not happening. And Curtis Nelson sticking around for some color here in the second period. Gonna see another, or we're not, or we are.
Yep. Yeah, no, I don't know. He's gonna do. I'm here for the looks, Rod. Just so you
gotcha.
Know.
Gotcha. Nobody better that I would choose.
I've got the face for radio.
It's a third power play for Carrot River here in the hockey game, and the faceoff is in the Assiniboia zone. Pankratz picks it up for them. Far right wing boards, but he lost it in his own skates. It's backhanded up and out by Chase Tenetuic on the Rebels penalty kill. For Carrot River, Drayton Havinson up the middle. Here's Weems in on the right side. Back to Weems. And he couldn't get his stick on the return feed. Top of the circle's left side. Here's Lahonen. He rings the post with a wrist shot. Blake Lahonen has one of the two Carrot River goals in this game. And he has it right corner. Puts it in front. And a one-time shot by A.J. True is blocked. Mealing got a pat on it. Rebound is centered and tipped away off the stick of Sweeting. Parker Sweeting, the big defenseman from Merrifield, got it out of the Assiniboia zone. It's in front of the Carrot River bench and now trickles into Assiniboia territory. Jaden Lapuliak, they say, got it out. Carrot River brought it back in offside.
So they've got a minute and 3 left in that power play for the Thunder here. A few good opportunities, but equal to the task with being in it.
Did you get in on the scouting report, Curtis, on Carrot River? Like this, do they lead the league, or are they going to?
They're kind of a lunch pail team, I think. They're hard workers. They have probably middle of the pack talents on their team, but they're known as one of the hardest working teams in the league. So you're not going to get any cheap goals on them, and you're going to have to work for everything you get.
Well, their head coach is Brian Node. Assistant coach is Shane Maynard, and they clearly do a great job. 52 seconds left in the Carrot River power play here. Faceoff to the left of the Assiniboia net. Draw man for the Rebels is Jaden Lapuliak. Puck comes to the boards. Dacey Timmons tied up over there. And then there's a battle for it in the corner. Matt Morhart working over the Carrot River forechecker down on the inboards. Pat Node. Puck comes free, and it's worked behind by Nathan Koontz. Around the net, and he centers. And Mealing there. Somehow he kept it out. Jumping puck over the net, and it's cleared around toward the right point and out. With 24 seconds to go in the penalty to Assiniboia here. Some pressure for Carrot River, but somehow Mealing kept it out. Koontz cruises in. Nathan Koontz for Carrot River. He gave it up in the near circle. It's wristed all the way down by Matt Morhart, and that'll about do it for the Carrot River power play. Somehow, they're going to be 0-for-3 on it in this game, despite a 2-0 lead. Here's a stretch pass, and Tristan Karen couldn't pick it up for Carrot River at the Assiniboia line. We're back to 5 aside. Puck is in the Rebel zone, middle point. The long shot by Rock is kicked away by Mealing. That Sweeting is a wrecking crew in front. And now here's a break. It's a clear breakaway for Ethan. Ethan Batchew, he's in, and he put it over the net. And in Moore and May got a piece of it, the Thunder goalie. That was the best scoring chance of the game for Assiniboia, and they couldn't convert. Now at center, Jordan Rayner for the Rebels. Back along his own line, through center on the right wing, and here's another lead feed, and it's out of the reach of two Rebels. Almost a breakaway chance for Jordan Johnson and Batchew. Thunder the other way as things have really picked up. On the far right side, Patnaud centered, and they couldn't get a clean redirection on the Assiniboia goal. It's taken behind by Ethan Batchew, Moose Jaw product. Now it's snapped off the near boards, but not out, held in by Karen. Rolled around the Assiniboia goal. Hadley Nakaneshny tied up over there for the Thunder. Puck comes free in front. It's curled to the line by Sigvason, but not out! And the point shot hit the post. You probably heard it. It came from A.J. True, and the Rebels were able to clear it down the ice. True on his own line. Threw it right up the middle on the tape of Brock Smith. Rebel forward is tied up. Coming over the Assiniboia zone, and here's Carrot River the other way. Hardy down the left wing side. To the net goes Karen. Here's the feed. And he was tied up very well in front by Lapulia. 2-0, Carrot River leads. 14:50 to go in this second period. Here's a giveaway by the Rebels. True in the right circle. Centers. And unable to get a stick free was Patnaud. Rebels out the other way. And had a chance for a break, but Carter Lamotte couldn't spy his man. Breaking. And the Thunder walk in offside. And I guess, Curtis, it took 20 minutes for these teams to get their legs free.
It was fire wagon hockey out there. Things have opened up quite a bit now. It looked like the old days of the 80s when the Oilers and the Flames were playing there. It's lots of trade and scoring chances there.
End to end is what you want. 18-7, though, Carrot River out shooting the Rebels to this point. Shots on goal for Chuck's collision. We are 5.5 into the second period. 2-0 for the visiting Thunder. But the Rebels are getting their chances. However, the puck is in their zone right now. Burt in this near left corner. Lee Burt gave the puck up. It's stolen and raced up ice by Logan Fontaine. He's over the Carrot River line. Stopped just inside it, however. Shot from the left circle is blockered behind by Andon Morin, the Carrot River netminder. Puck goes to the far corner. Tyre Rock, the defenseman, gave it up. It's turned over and centered, and Morin kicks it in back of the net. Nippon product in the Carrot River goal. The zone's cleared. J.C. Timmons back with a puck. He's bowled right over by Burt, the forechecking Carrot River forward. Centered for Hardy, and his wrist shot is held on to by Coulter Meeling, the Assiniboia goalie. How much do you know about this Rebels roster? Meeling, has he been around a while?
Yeah, Meeling's, I think, been with the team for 3 years now. He's a Moose Jaw product, and he's been their starter here for a couple years now.
Face off to his right. Rhett Franklin, the center for the Rebels, and he wins it cleanly off Weems. Far left corner, Aiden Lawless will play it up to center ice. Jumping puck blocked by Weems, and the Thunder are back in. Lahonen could do nothing with it in the high Assiniboia slot. It's brought the other way by Aiden Lawless on the right wing side. Trucks down to the corner, and he's rubbed out well by the defenseman Nathan Coons. 13:19 to go, second period, 2-0. Carrot River leads on the road here tonight. Todd Pankrat stick handles out of the Carrot River zone, and now on the near left wing side, it's Lahonen. Flim Flon product, centering pass, whistles through the low slot all the way over to the far right point. Ryan McNee feeds it in deep for Carrot River. They've got good control here now. Weems in the left corner, shot out of there, off Meeling's arm, it comes out to the right point for McNee. Snaps it down the boards into the far corner. Sweeting there. Rolls it up. Not out. High spot. The captain Weems a shot and a nice glove save made by Meeling. We will step back. 12:39 to go in the second. 2-0 Carrot River leads. This is Richardson Pioneer Assiniboia Southern Rebels hockey on Cat Country 98. Southern Rebels going to the power play for a third time into the box for Carrot River as Aiden Hansen, big rangy forward from, is it Kinistino? I'm joking. Kinistino. Who was it he hit down in front?
I didn't catch it. One of the D-men, but he gave a big cross check in the back. There he went down pretty hard. And he played there for a bit, but it looks like he's back up. I think the Rebels are getting set for the draw here on the power play. Good time to put one in the net to get the crowd in the game.
Well, it was a dirty shot. And uncharacteristic of what we've seen from Carrot River so far. A cross check to the head. I haven't heard what the announcement of the penalty is or not, but these are the kind of penalties that make you pay. Dumb ones, dumb penalties.
Exactly. In the offensive zone, and no need to cross check the D-man right there. You're behind the play. You should be looking for a pass to put the puck in the open net.
Penalty in the offensive zone. It was all around bad, and now would be a good time for the Rebels to bury it. Aiden Lawless is the center of this Rebels power play. Faceoff will be to the right side of the Carrot River goal. Rebels looking for their first goal of the game. Clear faceoff win by Assiniboia. Moorhart plays it down the left boards. Evan Krasowski's tied up over there. Aggressive forecheck by this Thunder team. It's hammered around toward the right point near side here. Carter Lamont can't hold it onside. Marhort's back forward here on the Assiniboia line. Puck rolled up the middle, and he unable to pick it up is Krasowski for the Rebels. And Salisbury for Carrot River walks in. Now it's Hardy, and he's tied up well. And I don't think this should be a penalty, but it's going to be a hooking call on Krasowski. I don't think it should be, Curtis, but the power play's up.
Yeah, it was a pretty weak call there. It looked like he went to lift his stick, but I think now in today's game, you get anywhere close to the hands, they seem to call that a hook. So
it's all right.
Could be some 4-on-4 hockey here for a while, so we'll have a little more open ice, and they're probably open to the ice, and we'll get a few more scoring opportunities here.
I was asked by one of the officials on Facebook to go easy on them before the game. You talk about how things have changed.
Exactly.
So it's 4-on-4. I said, call a good game. You'll have nothing to worry about. And no complaints here tonight, by the way.
We got a pretty veteran crew out there with Shane Smith. He's done a lot of Western League games.
We got a high stick puck here, and the faceoff will be outside the Carrot River blue line. 2-0 the Thunder lead. I just kind of feel like the momentum's turning a little bit, right?
Yeah, I think we've got boys seem to have a little more jump. They were definitely out hustled the first period, but I think the kind of the tables have turned here, and we've got a little bit of momentum for sure.
Puck tipped out of play off the faceoff, which is outside the Carrot River blue line to our right. Right in front of the Assiniboia bench. The Rebels captain, Aiden Sigvason, is taking the draw. He of Sylvan Lake, Alberta, but it's a face-off win by Weens, the Carrot River captain. And it's back in the Carrot River zone here behind the goal. Sigvason on it. Behind the back feed in front is stripped away by defenseman Tyler Rock. Prince Albert product will dance in front of his goal. Nifty feed to center here on the left wing side, and Burt is in for Carrot River. Cuts to the right side. Backdoor feed. What a goal. Weens there to finish it off. David Weens, and it's 3-0 Carrot River.
Yeah, that was a great goal by Weens there. It was set up with the speed down the wing and then cut in front of the net and then pass it back to the wide open net.
The time, 9:04. And it's very difficult for Coulter Meehlin to defend. I'll tell you what, Carrot River were crossing and crossing like the ice capades.
Yeah, it's still 4-4 hockey. Neither of the penalties has expired, so we'll see what happens here next.
Lahonen pokes the puck into the Assiniboia zone. He's got one of the three Thunder goals here tonight. Now the puck is free at center. Back on the Assiniboia line to our left, Brock Smith. Near right side for Moorhart. He'll cut in front of the Assiniboia net, dangerously so, and now behind it. Now Moorhart's away. Cross ice here on the near right side for Brock Smith. Upwards on the tape of Fontaine. He's in, and the pass in front couldn't hook up with Jaden Lepelia, who's hit hard here on the near boards. power play upcoming for Carrot River. Like they needed another one. Lahonen in on the left wing side, and his shot is tipped up into the mesh by Morehart. The mesh behind the Assiniboia net. And it's a power play for Carrot River, their fourth.
It looks like 34 seconds left in this power play for the Rebels to kill off here. 3-0 lead right now for the Thunder, so the Rebels need to hold strong here and try to get some momentum. I think they get a goal in the net here, they get the crowd back into it.
Patnode is the draw man, Tanner Patnode. He's from Kelvington, Saskatchewan. He wins the draw in the Assiniboia zone. It's hammered down in deep by the defenseman, Havidson. The near right point, True is stopped, checked, A.J. True, and the puck is flipped down the ice, and the penalty kill by Assiniboia is Aiden Lawless. One of two Merrifield kids on the Rebels roster, Parker Sweeting being the other. True forced in behind his goal here, A.J. True. Pass to Karen, back to True in the middle, dangerously, and Lawless got his stick in that breakout for Carrot River, muddling things up. Back to even up. The Outback Thunder are 0-for-4 in the power play. Patnode in for the Thunder. Wrist shot from the high slot, wide. Patnode gets it on the near left wing boards. Down into the corner, and it's centered from there. Jumping puck, they can't find a Thunder player in front, and Sweeting will bat it down the ice, and this will go as icing just narrowly on the Southern Rebels, and the faceoff will come back inside their zone. I missed it. Did Hurricane pry out of you on the intermission what your future fundraising efforts are going to be?
Well, we've got our lottery coming up again this year. The Spring Fever Lottery is our big fundraiser for the community, and we'll probably put a little more money into the rink. We've got a few ideas here yet, so we're going to continue to create the best facilities in the whole province.
Awesome. And in Morin races out of the Carrot River goal to play the puck. It's stolen in front. And keep that out of the save. On Sigfusson in front. The wildest sequence you're going to see of a goalie trying to play the puck. And the Rebels couldn't cash in. There's been hockey gods intervening at some point in this game tonight. I don't know what's going on.
They must have 3 or 4 open blocks at that time.
Yes. There's no reason that puck stayed up. Left point in the Assiniboia zone. Kuntz, the shot from the point goes off skates in front, but not on goal. Far right wing boards. Larry Flett plays it off the back of the goal. It comes into the near left corner. Back to Kuntz at the line, and his shot is blocked. And now, jarred out by Ethan Batchew to center ice. 8:10 to go in the second period. 3-0 Carrot River. Here's a feed up the middle, and it's brought in by Morgan Beauchamp. Drop pass, pounded wide by Hardy. Trey Hardy. Carrot River kid, he has it in the right corner of the Southern Rebels zone, but he's lost his footing. Rebels regain near right wing boards. Is that Lucalia? Need at center. Now it's backhanded into the Carrot River in by Carter Lamont on behalf of the Rebels. Bouncing puck in front again, and it's steered into the corner by defenseman Matthew Ratzlaff of the Thunder, who has it now behind his goal. His pass to the line is blocked, and out it comes. It's banked into the Assiniboia zone. Sweeting here in the near right circle, passed up the middle by Rayner to the center. He can't find a Rebels player there to connect. Carrot River gets it back. Ty Rock on his own line. Up the middle, and here come the Thunder again. Burt down the left side. Saucer to pass in front. He couldn't catch up with Cliff Salisbury. Now here's a lead feed. Throws it! Time of the goal, 13:06.
The Rebels have got her up to double digits in shots now, and that could be the jump they need.
We'll try and pick up the goal announcement. It was the Rebels number 10, and if you notice, the roster doesn't have a number 10.
Was that my fault? Sorry, Rod.
No, not saying that, but...
So it's always something good.
Mark is back here in the Assiniboia zone, right in the slot. Here's Truist's shot, kicked out by Mielek. We got a penalty now upcoming on Assiniboia. True was taken down in front of the net. It's Brock Smith that's going to go, and Carrot River's going to go back to the power play. When we come back, 6:20 to go in the second. 3-1, Carrot River leads the hockey game. This is Richardson Pioneer Southern Rebels Hockey at Cat Country 98. To the point on the power play, missed the D-man, it came all the way back into Carrot River territory, so they're back to pick it up. Tyler Rock, a long lead feed, misses everybody, and it comes deep into the Assiniboia zone, swatted at by Moorhart. He can't clear. Puck comes to the side of the net. Now far right wing boards, Lahonen, Blake Lahonen, tied up over there. He's got one of the Carrot River goals. Now Weens walks into the corner. He's slashed where his stick was, and Mieling leans out of the net and is able to cover up, as that is his 25th shot, I think, he's faced here in this game.
Things are getting a little chippy. There's a little pushing out in front here. The refs are trying to break them up right now. The linesmen are.
Well, I often wonder how they're not in the same division. It's the first game of the year. How do they hate each other so fast?
Yeah,
I often wonder.
I think it's inbred in hockey players to tell you.
I guess, yeah. Like I'm saying, it's not a seven-game series in April. You know. 58 seconds are left in the penalty to Brock Smith, Rebels defenseman. This game has been entertaining. There's no two ways about that. You know, the locals would like to see the score reversed. Right now, it's 3-1 Carrot River. The puck is behind the Rebels goal here in the left-hand corner. Aiden Hansen, that's Salisbury leaving it in there for Burt. Centering pass for True, and he couldn't, it was a high pass. He couldn't get it to sit. Here's a break. Parker Sweeting, the big defenseman down the left wing side. Parker Sweeting, shot from there. And a glove save made by Amden Morn, and it didn't look like Sweeting thought about passing too hard.
Oh, he hit a guy on the wide side. Probably thought, oh, I'll just get the shot on net here. Just made the pass to get through. I got the goal scorer. The first goal scorer for the Rebels of the season in the new arena is Numerich. This is the last name, Numerich.
Rylan Numerich, does that sound right?
I believe so.
13:06. I hope they got him the puck. I hope he cares. That's a big deal.
It is. First home goal in the facility. That's quite an accomplishment.
A.J. True has the puck now in behind the Carrot River goal. A long lead stretch pass here. Mieling the save on Salisbury, who was hiding in behind the Assiniboia Rebels defense. Great play. Better save by Mieling.
Yeah, they hit him for the long stretch pass. He was just inside the blue line there and shot high glove, but Mieling was there ready for the task.
I have to say something about the standing room only here. With the two rows, you can cram a lot of bodies in here.
Yeah, it's like you're right on the action there. It's an interesting feel inside the arena.
Just a few seconds are left in the Carrot River power play here right now. Remarkably, they're about to go 0-for-5 in this game, given such a tremendous effort in the 5-on-5, and they lead 3-1. Here is Moorhart for Assiniboia, circling in front of his net down to our left. Assiniboia in black jerseys with blue and orange trim. Here's A.J. True stealing the puck and centering. Oh, boy. was Burke there to finish and knock it home, and the Thunder are back up by three.
Yeah, he came out from around behind the net and passed to the wide open Burke in front of the net and tapped it in behind. The goalie didn't have any chance on that one.
Nope. Lee Burt, who's from Maidstone, Saskatchewan, scores to make it 4-1 at the even 60-minute mark, and it kind of took the air out of this building as people were starting to get excited.
Yeah, they definitely was an untimely goal for the Rebels, but we'll see here if they can put some pressure on to get another one back.
Puck on the Assiniboia blue line. Evan Krasuski, a pass through center. Tipped into the Carrot River zone. Now in behind the net. Tanner Patnode for the Thunder. Rolls it to the line. It's held in there by the Rebels. Jumping puck, high slot. And Hadley Nakonechny pokes it up. The assist going to A.J. True. The lone assist, Lee Burke with the goal. 4-1 Carrot River, 3.5 to go here in the second. We get another penalty upcoming, this to the Rebels. A delayed call, and I didn't see it. I was writing down the goal. Here at the other end, the puck is poked just wide of the Assiniboia goal by Karen. He's one of the smaller Carrot River players. He's cranked here, and he's down, not getting up. Sigvason with the hit, and I didn't think it was dirty.
No, I think he just went
awkwardly.
Went awkwardly in the boards. The Rebels player, though, is headed to the box here. A little pushing match in the corner, and the Rebels player, number six there, ended up on top of his Carrot River player, and they gave him the two-minute penalty.
Well, I'll tell you, the Rebels head coach, Mike Marhart, is going to have several teachable moments. I think that's what they call them now. Things to get mad about.
Exactly. I think he'll have a few things to say to the boys between the periods here.
Well, he's having a chuckle on the bench right now, but it is his sixth power play afforded Carrot River. This point shot by A.J. True is swallowed up by Coulter Mealing, and he'll hold on.
Yeah, shots are 26-13 right now for Carrot River, so they're shooting them 2-1 right now. The Rebels are going to have to stay out of the box if they want to have any hope to get this game back to equal.
This second period is brought to you by Westrum Lumber. And we appreciate the Westrum family support. I'm sure they're listening in. Puck is in the Assiniboia zone, far right corner, and a shot out of there by Tristan Karen is high on Mealing, and he'll hold on. It's a lot of rubber he's faced in this game.
Yeah, he's seen a lot of rubber the last few years for sure. That's, reading a few things on a few of the top goalies in the NHL, and they had one thing in common. They all played on teams where they got a lot of shots earlier in their career, and that continued forward.
Well, there's no doubt you get better the older you get as a goaltender, whether it's in the junior ranks or pros. There's no doubt about that. 2:37 to go in the second period. 4-1. Carrot River leads this game, and they are now on their sixth power play. Andon Morin out to play it. Their goalie behind the net. Brought ahead to center by Drayton Havidson, but we get a penalty behind the play. It's interference. It's a pick. It would appear Todd Pankratz does not like that call. And if he doesn't zip it, he might get a couple more.
Yeah, he's looking like he's going to go to the box here for 2 minutes. Another 4-on-4 opportunity for both teams. The Rebels got about a minute and 15 left in their penalty, and then they'll be going up 5-on-4. On the Carrot River Thunder here. So lots of room out there. Hopefully they can put one in the net.
Jaden Lepuliak, the draw man for Assiniboia, but the Thunder win this faceoff in their own zone in the 4-on-4 situation. Ty Rock, probably the tallest player on Carrot River, stick handles it, and he's good. On the left wing side, drives wide down around the Assiniboia goal to the far right corner, centers, and it's stolen and brought ahead by Lepuliak for the Rebels. Left side feed for Fontaine, gets in, and he lifted it over the net. Very close to cutting Carrot River's lead in half. Here's Burt in with some nice moves down the left wing side. He's got a goal here. Lee Burt. For Carrot River, left circle, Salisbury. Cliff Salisbury will skate out toward the line. Nice feed in front. Ratzlav will just clear it into the corner here for Carrot River. Stolen, lead pass. Dribbles in and a breakaway, and it's wobbled wide by Jordan Johnson. He fanned on it. I think the puck was rolling on him. Carrot River set to go on the power play for what I think is the seventh time. No, sorry, it'll be a power play, I think, for the Rebels. No, wait.
Rebels in 11 seconds will have a power play here. They've got 4-on-4 right now. Looks like there's another Thunder going to the box. So, yeah, we're right on. The Rebels will be going on a power play. We'll be going on a 5-on-3 here for the Rebels.
Power plays for Moose Jaw Truck Shop. And it's a big one. 4-on-3. As Nelly says, which statistically there's more goals scored 4-on-3 than 5-on-4. So we'll see. I think the Rebels will take whatever analytics they can. It's a face-off win in the offensive zone by Aiden Lawless, but it comes all the way back into the Assiniboia end.
He went it clean, but the D-man wasn't ready for it there.
So Matt Moorhart's back to get it. Local boy leading the charge ahead. Right side feed for Chase Tenetuit. Centering pass, tipped in on goal by Lalas. That's kicked away and actually out of play by Carrot River. And the faceoff's going to stay in their zone.
Yeah, into the Rebels bench there. The Rebels now got a 5-on-3 opportunity. So the faceoff down low. Really important draw for them here. They need to win that draw and keep the pressure on here and get that score to 4-2 here.
Lawless, one more draw win here in the offensive zone. And he has it now behind the goal. Aiden Lawless circles, plays it up the near right boards for Carter Lamont. Point shot is tipped in wide of the Carrot River goal. Right-hand corner, Lamont, right half wall. Out to the line. Moorhart's shot is just wide. Might have gone off the back of the mesh. You hear Nealon swatting his stick on the ice. It's now a 5-on-4. Here's a break for Hardy. For Carrot River. Walks the D. Backhanded shot saved. The rebound is there. It's underneath Nealon. And they're whacking away at it. It draws a crowd. And to be honest, I can't really blame the Carrot River player. The puck was loose and there was no whistle.
Yeah, a little late whistle there from Smith, but he was walking away and it looks like no more penalties here. The Rebels got about 55 seconds left in their power play, but they're going to be drawing the defensive zone here to the left of Mealing.
With only 12.7 seconds left to go. In the second period, draw man is Jordan Johnson for the Rebels up against the captain, David Weens. No, he's tossed out. It'll be Patnode coming in to take the draw. Tanner Patnode on the faceoff. Sigfusson charged ahead without it. Comes to Parker Sweeting in behind the Assiniboia goal. 3 seconds, two. And that'll do it. 40 minutes have gone by. And Curtis, I'm not sure if you'll be back on this broadcast or not, but I'll thank you now for coming on in the second and all your work in the pregame, man.
Yeah, he's not going anywhere.
Okay, good. Okay, there you go. I got the word from Hurricane. The intermission is on the way next. It is 4-1 Carrot River over the Assiniboia Southern Rebels through two periods. The Richardson Pioneer Assiniboia Southern Rebels, and you're listening to PJHL Hockey on Cat Country 98.
Saskatchewan storms can bring on some unfortunate damage. Trucks collisions here.
Bluetooth audio systems or...
is looking to rally the Southern Rebels here in this third and final period. We're just waiting to get the clock ready to rock, Curtis Nelson. Looks the players like are ready to go.
Looks like some technical difficulties here down below. We'll see what's going on.
There's been very few kinks or glitches with the clock until like now.
They got the period up now. It looks like number three just looking to try to get the time going here.
Well,
there they go. They got some time up there
nice
now.
Let's see what this third period has in store. The Rebels will defend the goal down to our right as we look at them. They're in their black home uniforms with orange and blue trim. The Carrot River Outback Thunder are in road whites with, what would you call that, burgundy?
Burgundy and gold, maybe?
I love it. I love
the
color.
Yeah, it's a great looking.
Now a penalty up coming right out of the gate here. Coming up delayed to Carrot River. Gliding through center with a puck is Carter Lamont over the Carrot River line. And from the near left wing boards, he's stick checked. And as they gave up possession, the call is made. And we've got a power. Well, in 13 seconds, it'll be a power play for Assiniboia.
I was just looking at the Carrot River outfit here. They remind me of the Sun Devils out of Phoenix.
Yes.
Exactly. Those exact same colors.
Yeah, that's for sure what they are.
See, I know something about sports. Yay, sports!
Yeah, Arizona. What a shock that you would know that school.
Yeah. Have you been to any Sun Devils games, Steve?
Yeah, actually I have. I was more of a Wildcats fan from the University of Arizona, but it was awesome. Sun Devils were amazing.
Now it's a power play for the Rebels. They're sixth. Remarkably, the power plays have drawn even. I can't believe how they do that, the officials. Here is, on the left wing boards, Brock Smith in the Carrot River zone, down into the corner. Now behind the goal for Aiden Wallace. He's checked. Rolling on its edge, up the near left wing side. Tenetuick couldn't get a stick on it. Far left wing boards. It's swatted down by Trey Hardy of Carrot River on the penalty kill. 1:09 to go on the Rebels power play. An early goal here would certainly do wonders as the Rebels break out on the power play, or try to. Parker Sweeting picks up the pass here along his own line, looks in the glass, sees who's coming, and he's checked in it. Or at least lost it, courtesy Todd Pankratz. Now it's skated up ice by Brock Smith of the Rebels, near left wing side. Going for the hip check is AJ Drew, but he lost that battle in a weight mismatch. And now Pankratz racing after a free puck down into the Rebel zone. And the first one back to get it is Jordan Johnson for Assiniboia. He'll stick handle up, scoops a pass on the right wing side. Rebels ran a delayed offside. 25 seconds to go on their power play. They couldn't bring it in. Sweeting back for the Rebels on their line. Pass into the middle of center. Fontaine over the line. Stick check by A.J. True, who's been one of the best Thunder tonight. Left point, Sweeting. Point shot kicked in wide by the netminder Andon Morin. And the Thunder will clear it up and up down the ice with the penalty just now expiring. It was Pat Node who shifted into the Assiniboia zone. Gathered up here on the right wing side by the Thunder. It's backhanded in front by Salisbury, but not on goal. He'll hold on. Nellie, I meant to ask, and if you can carry this for a few stoppages if you want. The Rebels were the first team to cancel their season because of COVID in the world.
Yes,
I think. And I'm sure they don't regret that.
No, they were kind of... The only unfortunate part for them doing that is they ended up losing all the players that they had signed, and they went up into a draft for the rest of the team.
Literally
so
lost them.
So that's why it's a big rebuilding process for them right now.
Well, I had no idea about that. But they'd do it again, probably.
Yeah, exactly. They would.
I thought they were leaders in that regard, but I'm sure it wasn't an easy decision. As now we're back to 5-on-5, 3 minutes into the third period. Thunder lead this hockey game 4-1. It's on the Carrot River blue line, taken now deep in behind their goal by Ryan McNean, Played over in the far corner. Now here's a stretch pass out of the reach of Lahonen. This icing is waved off. And play will go on here in this third period. Carrot River leading 4-1 on Cat Country. Puck along the left wing boards in the Assiniboia zone. It is poked out by Carter Lamont. It's in the referee circle right down below us. Fished into the Carrot River zone, and going back to get it is Ryan McNee. Pass out is blocked. Now a rolling puck. Beauchamp can't get it for Carrot River at the Assiniboia blue line. It's in front of the Rebels bench. Slides free into the Assiniboia zone. Near left wing boards, it is Sweeting. Must be leading the Rebels in ice time. Well, here's a huge giveaway right up the middle, but it slides out of the zone. Very lucky there for Jordan Rayner, the Mortlach product. Sweeting now behind the Assiniboia net, trying to avoid the forechecker. Leaves it for Rayner. Pass up the right wing, cleared rink wide through center, and brought in on the left side by Ryland Numerich, but they can't get a shot to the goal. Morehart. Oh, here's a dirty shot on Numerich on the near side. Kind of a side swipe, not from behind. Lead pass the other way, right on the tape of Hadley Nokonechny, but they're calling it an offside pass.
Yeah, just barely offside there, but the looks like the penalty's going to come all the way back to in front of the Thunder bench here, where they'll be taking the draw against the Rebels, number 21.
Yeah, Carter Lamont on the faceoff, and he wins it for Assiniboia in neutral ice. Brock Smith shovels it in wide of the Carrot River net. A.J. True back to get it. Battling behind with Lamont. Puck jumps up the far boards. True. Now to center. Here is a break for Salisbury. Down the left side, and the shot is into legs. Three puck in the Assiniboia zone. Jumped on by Carter Lamont. The Pontax product cleared it out. Knocked back in, but not far. Back in the neutral zone, it's A.J. True. Now for Burt. Lee Burt, who's got one tonight. He overskates it, coming into the Assiniboia zone. And it's in front of the Rebels bench, far side of center. Dealt in by Trey Hardy. Centering pass here right off the skate of the defenseman, Brock Smith in front. Almost on goal, but not. And it's jammed out by Carter Lamont. Shot back in by Carrot River. Gone a long time without a whistle here. At this point in the third, 4-1, Carrot River leads. Puck caroms into the Carrot River zone, taken behind the net by Drayden Havidson. Right circle for Beauchamp. Dangerous pass up the middle, but it does come out to center. Ethan Batchew for the Rebels along his line. Pass to center for Dacey Timmons is blocked. It's along the center red line, and now pushed into Carrot River territory. Havidson on it near corner. Leaves it in here for A.J. Truth. Lead pass blocked by the Rebels captain, Sigvason. It comes behind the Carrot River net. A.J. True, far corner. He's got time, and he'll flip it high in the air out to center. Gathered up on the Rebels line by Dacey Timmons, and advanced the other way, and just backhanded in by Batchew, who will go off for a change. Beauchamp through center with the pass. He connects with Larry Flett. He'll roll it in. 13-10 to go in the third. 4-1. Carrot River. Bodies are flying here as the puck is rushed up ice. It's just inside the Carrot River line. Jordan Rayner can't secure it. Deep in their zone, it's Ryan McNee for the visiting Thunder. Rolls it behind the goal. Kuntz in there, and he's pinned along the boards. Pass up on the near right wing for Beauchamp. He's tied up. Brought free by Lupuliak. Walks to the goal. Can't get a shot away, and it slides in on end and more. And he's had a pretty easy, frankly, third period, Curtis.
Yeah, he's another lot of shots there. It was an easy one. Just rolled up to him as he covered there. It looks like there's going to be a draw to his left here on the face of the offensive zone for the Rebels right now.
Kind of feel like they're smaller goalies, but they're probably not that small. But I've been used to watching Sergei Bobrovsky. These guys are 6'5". He's guy. Everybody looks short compared to them. Here's Weens. He's had a great game. The Thunder captain, right side feed of the line, Lahonen. Left side feed here. Shot into the goal. They score. Weens was left all alone in front, and it's 5-1 Thunder.
Yeah, shot from the side there, and rebound kicked right in front to Weens, and he just taps it into the open net.
David Weens with his second of the game makes it 5-1 Carrot River. And they don't take long to burn you when they get a chance.
No, exactly. They seem to be taking advantage of their opportunities a lot more than the Rebels are tonight. Shots are 29 for the Thunder and only 16 for the Rebels.
Two goals and an assist for David Weens in this game. They've had a lot of guys have great individual performances, and now 6-1. Todd Pankratz.
Shot to the low to the glove side there, and it gets past the goalie wheeling, and the road looks like it's on right now. The Thunder really pounced on to get two quick goals there and kind of taking the life out of the bench here.
15 seconds after the Weens goal, Todd Pankratz scores, and it's 6-1. And you really got a feel, I do anyways, for Colter Mueling in the Rebels net. Because Carrot River is not laid off. They've made the most of their opportunities. The Rebels have not been able to here tonight. Here's the announcement on from Mark Lechaire. Here's Sigvason over the Carrot River line. He's stick-checked by Ratzlaff coming in. Thunder the other way. Tristan Caron on the far left wing boards leaves it in the far corner. Now it's picked up in that far circle and unable to clear it out is Jordan Johnson. He'll get it now in the corner. Jordan Johnson, loose job on it, cleared it to the line. Not out. The point shot. Mueling got a piece of that on the near right wing boards. Nakaneshny bumped to the ice by Sweeting. I think that's Nakaneshny. It is. Rebels the other way. From center, a long shoot-in by Batchu goes wide. Assiniboia getting a wholesale change.
Oh, opportunity in front there.
Yeah, quick low shot and kicked out by Moore. This is another Rebel, number six, who is not on the roster. We'll take a timeout. 11 minutes to go in the third. 6-1 Carrot River leads on Cat Country 98. Duck. Does the puck slides in on Mueling. Now, this is a tough decision, just to get into the analysis a little bit, for Mike Morhart. Do you pull Mueling, knowing not really his fault?
No, maybe give the other young goaltender there maybe a shot at it. So the Deems obviously had a hand in 7-1 with 10 minutes left, and maybe get the opportunity to give your other goalie some playing time.
Well, as a former goalie myself, who may or may not have given up 7 or 8 goals from time to time, I would pull myself after the next one. See ya! Which may still happen. And now we got a penalty coming up. Shane Smith with a call. Cross-checking against one of the Carrot River forwards, am I correct?
Yeah.
Carrot River players, yeah.
Yeah, number 15 for Carrot River there, right off the draw. He cross-checked the other centerman there. And Shane Smith was quick to jump on that one.
Well, I hope, I really hope, this does not degenerate into a penalty situation here. Stupidity.
No, I think it's early up in the year. I think the kids want to be playing tomorrow, so I think there's a lot of guys. I think both teams play on Saturday as well here, so they're going to want to be on the roster for the next game.
So it's a seventh power play for the Rebels, and the faceoff is in the Carrot River zone down here in the left-hand corner. Fontaine centers. Sweeting couldn't get it in the high Carrot River slot. It's tipped to the line by Sweeting and out. Sigvason comes back to play it in neutral ice for Assiniboia. Left side feed eludes Jaden Lapulia. Carrot River has it here in the near corner, and it's ripped all the way down the ice by Ryan McNee on their penalty kill for the sixth time. 31-17 of the shots on goal in favor of the Carrot River Outback Thunder. Shots on goal, as always, for Chuck's Collision. Puck is in the Carrot River zone here. Right side, Lapuliak was rattled into the boards. That's what you heard. Big hard hit by Larry Flett on the near boards. Again, the Thunder able to deal it all the way down the ice, and they'll get a change to their killers with 50 seconds left to go on the Assiniboia penalty. You gotta love this crowd. Nobody's left.
Yeah, it's still a full house. People are looking for something to cheer about here.
A shoot-in is covered up by the Carrot River goalie, Andon Morin. He didn't want to take any chances or keep the play moving, so the face-off will be to his left side.
Rebels got 37 seconds left here on the power play, so we'll see here what they can do with it.
Aiden Lawless is the draw man for Assiniboia, but it's a face-off win by the visitors, Cliff Salisbury, and the zone is cleared one more time. Chugging back to get it is Mike Morehart, or sorry, his kid, Matt Morehart. Rebels break out, left side passes into the skates of Lamont. Now comes free at center, big Brock Smith for the Rebels. Stick handles over the line, gets stood up on the far boards by Rock, Tyler Rock. But the Thunder can't get the puck. It's in the left corner for Lawless. Behind the goal for Chase Tenetua. Far right side to the line. Pushed in deep by Morehart. The penalty's up. Long wrist shot from the left wing boards by Brock Smith. Handled by Morin. Rebound stays in play. It's in front of the net. And the goal! Was saying, you know, earlier, junior hockey, you literally never know. And I'm not saying the Rebels are going to come back, but I don't think they're going to quit either. And here comes Rebels on again for the Rebels. Unassisted goal, they're saying, at 11:46 of the third period. 7-2 Carrot River. Now they got a 2-on-1. Puck carrier on the left side is Hardy. Nice move in front, goes to the backhand and then slides it wide. And Morehart, he picked it up. His pass hit the ref skate and jumped right in front. Now it's on the left wing boards. Hardy. Oh boy, right in front, and they score. Is that Salisbury was left all alone?
Well, we got some rough stuff now. Yeah, Salisbury took the feed from the left boards and was left all alone out in front of the net, and took it from the left to the right and put it in the open net of the goalie.
Well, and Salisbury had all day to do it.
There wasn't a Rebel within 20 feet of him there.
And he comes straight to the penalty box. I think it was Salisbury who got mauled after the goal. I didn't see what drew the crowd after the goal, other than, is that an over-the-top celebration?
I'm not sure. He lost his helmet there, so the ref's picking his helmet and his stick up, and he's in the penalty box right now. So see what the call is. Shane Smith with the call here right now.
Our post-game show sponsors are Integra Tire Assiniboia and Dave Mahalitz Excavating. It'll be interesting to see what we do for three stars. Oh, boy. Turning point of the game, Hurricane. Jad Arden.
They got Jess Moskaloo playing right now here. I guess she was the concert we had in here to open up the facility here a couple weeks ago.
I'm glad you said Jan Erden and not me.
Oh, boy.
Okay, well, anyway, the boys are doing good. They're getting figured out. It's first game. Come on, guys. We still have 7.5 minutes for the hockey left here.
Yeah, everybody seems to, all the fans seem to be having a good time here yet.
So. Absolutely. A few long faces, but you know what? I mean, this place is packed.
Yeah, no, we were saying that. Nobody's left. That's impressive.
Yeah, it's the score maybe isn't what we like, but the atmosphere in here is still fantastic. Everybody seems to be having a good time. The temperature is about 25 degrees warmer than the old barn, and it's still a treat to watch.
Was that part of the planning too, to have it this comfortable in here?
Yeah, we basically set the temperature at 13 degrees for a game, so it'll be, whether it's 40 below outside, it'll be the same temperature here.
Wow. It is a power play, interestingly enough, for the Rebels, so I don't know what Salisbury did. I haven't seen too many guys score a goal and then take a penalty.
I think it was a little over the top.
Is that what he was?
Taunting?
It was a little taunting. Those are the kind of penalties that drive you nuts as a coach, too. That's just dumb. Anyways, Rebels on the power play, and they work it in. Here's Sweeting in the top of the left circle. A shot kicked away by a screen. Andon Moore and got a left toe on it. Back out to the left point for Jordan Johnson. Down the board, Sweeting into the corner for Fontaine. And they can do nothing with it. A.J. True takes it away for the Thunder, and he backhands it straight up into the rafters, and it does not come down.
I think it's into the crowd here.
Yeah.
56 seconds left in the Ripples power play, and 6:25 left in the game. Thunder up 8-2 over the hometown Ripples right now. So they get an offensive zone faceoff here and an opportunity to maybe put another goal and get their goal song playing one more time today.
Left point in the offensive zone. Landon McClellan for the Rebels. A pass in front is broken up. Todd Pankrat's got his stick in the lane. And the Thunder's able to clear with 40 seconds to go in their penalty. Skated back in by Landon McClellan. Karrenport product for the Rebels. Pass to the line for Morehart. And his shot is right in on goal. Saved by Moore, and the rebound's underneath him. And it's jammed free to the right wing boards. Morehart's stick check there. By the forechecking Pankrats, it comes all the way down the ice. Pankrats is a great example of this Carrot River team. They don't quit at all. Right back in is Lamont with a shot from the right wing side, and it's held on to by Moore for a defensive zone faceoff for Carrot River.
Yeah, the Thunder players, they got seem to have a lot more jump than the Rebels right now this early in the season here, but they're basically a lunch pail team, and like we mentioned at the start of the broadcast, that they're not going to give up anything and they're not going to quit.
Wallace is the faceoff man for the Rebels. And on the draw, they got a quick shot. Assiniboia did. Chase Tenetuic kicked up by Morin, who's been very good when called upon in the Carrot River goal. Just a couple seconds left in the power play. Lamont!
Nice score!
On the power play! The Rebels win. Chase Tenetuic carried.
Puck squirted out of the corner into the front of the net, and he jumped on it, and he buried it for close range in front of the Thunder goal. Giving the hometown crowd a little bit of something to cheer about with 5:29 left in the game. The Thunder now lead the Rebels 8-3. Shots are now 20 for the Rebels and 32 for the Thunder.
timeout called by the Thunder there, so we'll have a 30-second timeout to get their team calmed down here.
I'm certainly not going to argue with the coaching of Brian Node, who clearly is an expert head coach, but did you feel that they were that running around? I didn't.
I might be. I'm guessing it's more going to be keeping the kids composed here and maybe not taking a bunch of stupid penalties here. I'm guessing is the chat they're going to have here. With an 8-3 lead, I don't think there'll be much more needed to say than keep your heads here and stay to the penalty box.
Okay, so the faceoff ready to go right in red center. 8-3, the Carrot River leads, by the way, in case you didn't know. Sigfridsson is the center for Assiniboia, and is flipped in. Rainer skated around the net and throws it out to the line. Bounced back in deep by Retzlaff. And Sweeting is on it behind the net for the Rebels. He'll flip it up to center ice. Sent back in, and here's Sweeting on it in the near corner for the Rebels. Plays it out, sent back in by Retzlaff. 4.5 to go in this game. 8-3, the Thunder leads. Sweeting. Long lead feed is out of the reach of Lee Burt, and it's going to be an icing call on Assiniboia.
4:26 left in the third here. Shots are 32 for the Thunder, and 32 for the Thunder, and 20 for the Rebels. Thunder's leading the game 8-3 right now. So we got an offensive zone draw for the Thunder left of Mealy.
Off the faceoff. There's a battle in the corner for it, far left side. Centered now, Salisbury pounds it over the net. Well, that's Tanner Patnode, and it goes for a whistle. We'll be right back as the net is knocked. It's our 4:16.
Now that we have a break, we'll do the 50-50 number. Tonight's prize is $2,080, and the winning ticket number is A as in Albert, M as in Michael, 4-036949. That's A as in Albert, M as in Michael, 4-036949. If you have that ticket, please go to main entrance.
Slides out front, the goaltender Mealy will jump on it for a stoppage. The first of a 40-game regular season here tonight for both teams, the Southern Rebels and Carrot River. Carrot River making a long trip down here to open up the regular season.
Yeah, quite a few miles on the bus for these kids. The junior ranks, the hours they spend in a bus can take its toll, that's for sure.
We've got an icing call here. Coming up on Carrot River, the faceoff will be down in their zone to the right side of Andon Morin. Just looking at their roster, by the way, by way of hometowns for Carrot River, just from top to bottom. Carrot River, Carrot River, Tisdale, Prince Albert, Carrot River, Carrot River, Priestville, Valmont, BC, Duck Lake, Kelvington, Kinistino, The Paw, Snowden. So they got the northern half of the province covered very well. Cumberland House, Maidstone, Flin Flon, Nipawin. And a lot of the south here for the Southern Rebels, which is great to see.
Up with a puck on that far post, and more times than not, they've been burying it.
Trey Hardy is the Carrot River faceoff man with a draw in the Assiniboia zone, and he wins it. Top of the circles, Lee Burt got it, but he couldn't get a shot away, and the Rebels rush up ice with it, but stopped breaking in is Lapulia. Dacey Timmons stick handling through center for the Rebels, but he stick checked. Now it is batted in to the Carrot River zone. Here in the near corner, Drayton Havidson can do nothing with it. Now it plays it up on the left wing boards, and the Thunder are away again. Sent in deep by Hardy. He's still going after it. Far right wing of the Assiniboia zone, Carter Lamont jams it out, and he'll go off for a change now. 5 for 5 changes for the Southern Rebels. Gives Carrot River time to break out. Lee Burt bringing it through center, and he is body checked in neutral ice by Jordan Johnson, a textbook body check there. Parker Sweeting comes away with the free puck and plays it behind the Assiniboia net. Rebels break out with 2:15 left to go. Jordan Rainer's pass is errant through center, comes into the Carrot River zone. Sigfridsson, the Rebels captain, tried to center and it didn't go. It's flipped high and down the ice into Assiniboia territory. Sweeting's back to get it. He'll lead the charge the other way. High dump in from center, jams off the dasher behind the Thunder goal. AJ True can't get it in the corner. Now it's brought up ice by Larry Flett for the Thunder. Drop pass, Weems. And just steer it into the far corner for Carrot River. From the left wing of the Assiniboia zone, it's passed out by Jordan Johnson. Thunder recollected at center, but can't get it in deep. Morehart rolls it off the glass, up for Lawless. Aiden Lawless tried to cut to the Carrot River net, and he stick checked. Zone cleared. Dealt back in by Assiniboia's Carter Lamont. 1 minute to go here in the first ever game at Southland Co-op Center. Puck is free at center ice. Brock Smith came over for it for the Rebels. He can't find it. It was jammed high in the air. Zeroed in on by Chase Tenetuic. He's got one of the Rebels' goals here tonight. He can't advance it. Brock Smith back on the Assiniboia blue line. Over here, near side for Morehart. He'll roll it right up the middle. It trickles into the Carrot River zone. It pounces the defenseman back to get it and clear it off the glass and out. And it's brought back in offside by Morehart. By the way, Curtis, that seems like very high glass along the side.
Yeah, we put eight-foot glass around the whole facility, so the whole ice surface has got 8 foot glass. The idea is keep the puck in play a lot more and a lot fewer whistles.
Looks good.
Yeah. The guys have to change it, maybe I'm kind of the happiest with people.
Yeah, that would be very difficult. 24 seconds left to go. We get a high stick puck here, and they're going to blow it down in neutral ice. Well, the ref said to go easy on him, and I will say this, in a 9-8-3 game, can't complain about officiating tonight, I don't think.
Yeah, they've kept pretty good control of the game, that's for sure.
Lapouliak for Assiniboia off the draw against Hardy at the Carrot River blue line. Thunder win the draw, and it's raced up ice by Tyler Rock. He's had a great game for Carrot River. It's tied up on the far boards. The puck comes in behind. Pankratz with some nifty stick work there. Nifty centering pass, too. Stolen away, though, by Logan Fontaine. He'll clear it off ice, and that will do it. The very first game in Southland Co-op Center goes to the visitors. The Carrot River Outback Thunder, your final 8-3 over the Assiniboia Southern Rebels. The Richardson Pioneer Assiniboia Southern Rebels. We'll be right back with the post-game show in a moment. You're listening
Winter
to...
Winter is coming.
Great West Auto...